Thi Nga kính chào quý khán thính giả đến với SBGN DC bản tin Hoa Thịnh Đốn phát hình lúc 1 giờ 30 trưa Chủ nhật năm Thanh Giêng dương lịch 2014, mở đầu với tiết mục WPG Kỳ này giới trẻ nói đến các mục tiêu cho năm mới. Sau đó là chương trình Thanh Giêng của Hội Thánh Tin Lành Baptist Phục Hưng. Thưa quý vị, cứ mỗi đầu năm dương lịch là chúng ta có lệ đặt ra các điều tâm niệm để cố gắng thực hiện. Giới trẻ Hoa Kỳ có các mục tiêu ra sao? Phan Thùy Lan trao đổi với nha sĩ Trần Thoại Lân về các mục tiêu đó như sau.
Welcome, I'm Thùy Lan Phan, the host for today. There's many things that we wish to achieve in life. And what would our life be without goals and objectives? More importantly, do we really need to set goals and objectives for ourselves in order to achieve in life? Our topic today will be on the importance of setting goals. We have here Dr. Len Tran. He's an orthodontist working at Novel Smiles in Tysons Corner, Virginia. Dr. Tran, for most people, success takes a combination of hard work, determination, motivations, as well as a little bit of luck. Do you have any tips on the importance of building goals in everyday success?
I think this topic is a great topic to talk about with this time of year, especially with New Year's resolutions. And one of the main things I want to focus today are two things about setting goals. The first is, well, how does it help us succeed? And the second is, how do we go about setting the goals correctly? Now, what is the importance of setting goals? It's to take what we have in here and to put it out and make it clear. They did a study at Dominican University several years ago where they followed 200 people from different fields of interest. And they, over the years, they tracked them and then they measured how successful they were. And they used their terms of success in terms of financial achievement. What they found was that the people who simply just had goals, talked about it, they made far less than those who actually wrote their goals down. Now, interestingly enough, the people who wrote their goals down, they compared those to both who wrote them and then who had a means or a strategy of achieving those goals. And they found that those people who not only wrote their goals down, but also came up with a game plan were 50% more likely to be more successful. They finally took that group and divided into two smaller groups. And they found that those people who not only just wrote their goals down, had a game plan, but gave feedback to someone every week on how they were doing, were the most successful out of this whole group of people. So what this study thing shows and demonstrates is that if we write our goals down, if we have a game plan, and if we have someone that we can work through with it, we are 50% more likely at each event to be more likely to achieve what we want in life.
So Dr. Tran, really setting goals accomplishes three things. So it's make your vision clear, it makes you committed, and as well it makes you accountable for your life and what you want to achieve. What do you think about that?
Yes, I mean, I think you hit it right on the spot. And those three things are the main goals of goal setting. And it sounds so simple, and it is. It's because it's the simple things we do every day that kind of leads to success. You know, we always think success happens overnight, and that isn't the case. These people took years of figuring out what they wanted, figuring out why they wanted it, and then figuring out a way to get there. So when I talk about goal setting, I want to focus on how do we go about achieving that. What's the right way of setting goals, and then how are we going to make sure we are making good progress?
So, Dr. Tran, how often do you recommend people, especially students, revisit their goals?
Well, one of the things about goal setting is the more progress reports you make, both to yourself or the people you're working with, the more likely you're going to be accountable and the more likely you'll be motivated. Now, when I talk about setting goals, the most important part of starting the goal setting is how you even create or why do you create these goals. So one of the things with the new year coming up is take some time to yourself, minimum 1 hour, find yourself in a quiet place where there's no distraction from cell phone, Facebook, internet, and just sit and just think about all the things you want to achieve, both in this year and the next 5 or 10 years. Come up with the list, be crazy, be dramatic, dream. This is your time to get it all on a paper. Once you do that, then you can kind of get the process started.
So, you know, it's easy to make plans and goals, and how do you recommend people, I mean, what methods do you recommend people to follow in order to keep up or accomplish their goals?
So the first part of making the ideas and the goals is the easy part. The second part is how do you keep committed? And what I want to focus on is you need two things to give you that drive. You need logical reasons and you need emotional reasons. And we all know that emotions put us into motion to achieve the goals we want. So come up with as much logical and emotional reasons, but more importantly, think of all the obstacles that are going to come along the way. Think of all the things that you might have to struggle just to get there, and then envision what it feels like to get to the end point. When you start visualizing that ahead of time, what it does is you're prepared for the challenges that come ahead, so you don't give up too soon. But more importantly, you start thinking of solutions. You start thinking of ways that, how am I going to get over this hump? What skills do I need to learn this? What are the things I need to start improving on? And when you start doing that in all parts of your life, you become a solutions finder and not just a problem finder.
Thanks for watching. I'm Thuy Lan Phan. Our team at AA Success, Dr. Tran, Q2, and Dave would like to wish you a happy new year.